Good morning, students. In today's live class, we learned a new chapter, that is computer hardware and software. So in this chapter, we are going to cover various topics like hardware and software complement with each other. So let's begin the chapter. Hello friends, in the previous chapter you learnt about computer system, which is a combination of hardware and software. Now let us learn about hardware and software. So first we are going to learn about hardware. So before that, in our chapter it is said, in the previous chapter we learned about computer system and we have seen that it is the combination of hardware as well as software. So now we are going to learn the what is meant by a hardware and what is meant by a software. So all the physical equipment that are attached to a computer are collectively called hardware. You can touch and feel the hardware. Hardware includes various components like system unit, input device, processing device, output devices, and storage devices. So all the physical machines or the equipment which are in front of us and we use for doing the work in a computer, that is known as hardware. So hardware is a thing which we can touch and feel. So for example, the computer systems monitor, keyboard, scanner, so these things which we can see, so those things are known as hardware. So hardware can be seen, can be touched, and can be felt. So we can feel it, we can touch it, and we can see hardware. So hardware have various components. That is, first component is system unit. System unit is a plastic or metal case that stands near the monitor. It protects the internal electronic components from damage. It is also called computer case. Every computer has a system unit or computer case. It is available in a variety of shapes and sizes. So first we are going to learn about computer or system unit. So system unit is a metal case or a plastic which helps to stand near the monitor, and it helps for internal electronic components or to protect electronic components from damage. So not causing damage to the computer, for that purpose we are using computer or system unit. Computer case or system unit. So here you can see some of the examples like desktop case, tablet case, notebook case, smartphone case. So here you can see, for protecting these things or these machines, it is covered with a plastic thing or a metal thing. That's why it is known as system unit. Next thing we are going to learn is input device. What is meant by input device? The data or instruction we enter in the computer is called input. A hardware component that allows you to enter data and instructions into a computer is called an input device. Input devices are mainly external device connected to system unit from outside. Some input devices are keyboard, mouse, scanner, joystick, touchscreen, etc. So what is meant by input device? The information or the instructions which we are storing in the computer, for storing that things we are using various devices. So those devices are known as input devices. So input device we can see, or it used to be in front of us, like keyboard, mouse, scanner, touchscreen, or joystick. So we are going to see for what all purpose we are using this input devices. First is keyboard. Keyboard is used to enter data into a computer. For entering the informations, we are using keyboard. Next is mouse. We use mouse to draw pictures or diagrams or to select any of the information or any options in the computer. We are using mouse and it is also known as pointing device. Next is scanner. It is used to enter images, text or drawing into the computer. So whenever we are scanning any of the image or any of the drawing, it is automatically stored in the computer. So for that purpose, we are using scanner. Next is joystick. Joystick is an input device which is used for playing games. So next is touch screen. It is used by simply touching the screen with our fingers. So here our fingers act as pointing device. So in the monitor, mouse used to act as pointing device. In the touch screen, our fingers used to act as pointing device. So here you can see the know the fact. There you can see who have invented the scanners. Scanner was invented by Rushel Kirish at US National Bureau of Standards in 1957, and first he took the scanning of 5 cm photograph, which is of his 3-month-old son Walden. So that was the first image scanned by him after making the scanner. So now we are going to see processing device. After getting the data or instruction from input device, computer processes the data and change it into information with the help of processor or CPU. So why we are using processing device? So to change any of the information or data into a proper thing, or if we have to change any of the data or instruction into a proper information, we are using processor or central processing unit. So central processing unit used to act as the brain of a computer, and it used to help us in all the calculation and the data work which is there, which we need in a computer. While we are operating the monitor or the computer, we need the help of CPU for calculation as well as to process the data. So for those purpose, there are components of CPU. They are ALU. So what is meant by ALU? Arithmetic Logic Unit, which performs arithmetic comparison and logical operation. So what is meant by arithmetic operation? So arithmetic operations are those things which helps in the basic calculations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and the division. Next is comparison operation, which involve the comparison of greater than, equal to or less than. So these kinds of comparison, it is used comparison operation. So we use comparison operation for comparisoning one data to with another. Next is logical operation, in which we can use or in such thing we are using the words and or not. So these words, if we are missing while typing or giving the data in the computer, it is used to enter automatically in the computer. Next is control unit. So control unit is a unit which helps to control the functions of a computer, as well as it used to check how what we have to do or how we have to do, when we have to do the things in the monitor, and it gives the result with the help of ALU in our computer. Next is memory unit. Memory unit stores the data or information which can be taken out and changed anytime whenever required. The memory unit is a thing which stores data or information whenever taken out or changed, and it can be changed anytime whenever we want to change it. So memory unit helps us to store the information in a computer for longer time. Even if we want after 10 years, 20 years, it will be there in our computer. So for that storing purpose, we are using memory unit. So here you can see the functioning of processing unit, that is input, then processor, then output. Input gives data, processor processing work, and after the processing it gives us information. So in today's class we learned only this much. So now what you have to do, you have to read this chapter 3 times thoroughly and you have to understand each and every concept properly. So thank you everyone.